everyone, this is Maria and this is my collecting habit. In this video, I'm going to share our flea market haul from the Long Beach Flea Market back in May. The Long Beach Flea Market is held every third Sunday of the month. Sometimes if there are five Sundays in the month, then they will have it twice a month. And so that's what they did in May, although Joey and I, we could not make it both Sundays in May. So maybe in October we'll be able to do that. But anyways, let me go ahead and start off with something that Joey found at the flea market, and it always makes me happy when he finds something that he really wants and he's willing to pay for. This is a Tonka truck. It's vintage, it's made of metal. You can see it's really just really old and sort of rusted out. It's got this crane, and you can see this scoop thing. You can see how rusted it is. And it says mobile clam on here. And you can move it out this way. It's got all the tires. So this is the first thing that I got at the Long Beach Flea Market for myself. This is a Francie doll case. Now Francie is Barbie's cousin, her hip cousin in the 1960s, around 1966. I had a Francie when I was a kid. Look at that cute little outfit, mod outfits of the time. And so let me go ahead and open this. Look at the shape of this. I paid $20 for this, you guys. And so it does have a little bit of damage up here where it was torn, probably from being opened so many times. There's a little accessory box here and you could hang some of the little fashions there. I thought for $20, it was a pretty good deal. I really liked it and it really drew my attention, probably because I had a Francie doll. And so $20 I thought was pretty fair. And so you guys, now I just need to buy a Francie doll. And so it gives me something to look for, right? And also some of the outfits. So a few months ago, I went to a local estate sale where they had a lot of dolls for sale. And one of the dolls that I purchased for $15 was a Pebbles Flintstone vinyl doll. And so she was made by the Ideal Toy Company. And I was really excited to find her. And so when we went to this flea market a couple of months ago, I was really surprised to find the box, the empty box, you guys. Look at this. And so you could see where it was torn, and but I didn't really care about that because the box was only, I think, $10, $10 or $15, something like that. I want to say more $10. And so, but you could see where there's the tear right across here. And so, but it was the empty box, and I thought, what are the odds of me ever finding this box again? So I just went ahead and put some packaging tape on it, and you know what? That works for me, you guys. But look how cute. It says Ideal, the Ideal Toy Company, and there's Pebbles, Tiny Pebbles Flintstone, and there's her mommy and daddy, which is Wilma and Fred Flintstone. It looks like there's some writing on here. Someone has written on the front of the box. Here's the side of the box. It's all cardboard. I mean, this is a very old box from the 1960s. Just really, really old. And then you could see the back. This is like this wire thing. It's covered, I think, like with paper of some sort. And so we basically it ties the doll inside the box. And so let's go ahead and take a look inside. But basically, I wanted to show you the box, you guys. I mean, if I found this doll, this Pebbles doll, inside the original box, like let's say on eBay or even somewhere else, it would sell for a lot of money, you guys. But I have $15 into the doll, and I'm pretty sure it was $10 for the box. And so I was so excited. So let's go ahead and open this. You have to be very careful because you can see how thin the cardboard is, you guys. And you can see where I taped it up. I taped it on this side and on the front. And then here is the Pebbles. I'm just gonna show her to you once again. Look how cute. She's in pretty good shape. I do need to find the little bone to put in her hair, and I do need to make her little black shorts. And so this is her original top, and you can see how she's tied in, but her face is really cute, really pretty. So back in the 1960s, when I was playing with my Barbies and little Kittles, I also wanted Trolls, but I couldn't have them because I just couldn't have everything, you guys. But I do remember collecting the little mini Trolls out of the bubblegum machines, kind of like these right here. And so on this day, I told Joey that I was looking for Trolls because I kind of tell him things that I'm looking for when we get to the flea market because he has a really good eye. And so he found a little basket on the ground at a seller's booth, and he picked it up and showed me and said, hey, there's some trolls. And I was so excited because I got this one right here. Look at this one. And so this one has the markings. It's pronounced Dam, D-A-M. And so, but look at her hair. It reminds me of sherbet ice cream. Isn't this cute? It looks like from the 1960s. I'm not sure, but that's what it looks like. Although it says China, made in China, but it does have the word Dam on here, D-A-M. And so the markings, I believe, are right here on the feet. Sometimes you'll find the markings on the back also. But I really love her hair. And then her little outfit, I remember this so much from when I was a kid because the kids that brought their trolls to school had outfits and I noticed they were made of felt. And so that just caught my eye and I really, really like that. This is a 3-inch troll. And so we paid $10 for all of this, these little mini trolls, this 3-inch troll. And oh my gosh, you guys, what were the odds of finding this? This is the original pattern. It's not a laser copy, it's the original. And so they were in a little plastic bag, like a little sleeve. And so I definitely wanted this. It said it was $4. So we paid $10 for all of this, which was a great buy. But look at all of the fashions that you could make. It says here, felt togs for troll dolls. And then it says on here, the pattern, it says one pattern includes two sizes, 3-inch and 6 dolls. It's McCall's, which you can still buy McCall's patterns today. It's kind of like Simplicity and Vogue. And it says printed pattern. And so I opened one of them and it has never been cut. All of the pattern pieces are there and the instructions. What I didn't notice though, until I took it out of the package, is there are two patterns. It's the exact same pattern. And so you can see, I'll flip it around. This one has been cut though, although there are a lot of pieces in here and the instructions. And so I'll probably use this one when I start making clothes for them. I thought the perfect felt to use would be the felt that you can get at Hobby Lobby that has so many cute prints. If you haven't seen those, go over to Hobby Lobby and check them out. So it's kind of ironic because I always wondered, what can I make from that felt at Hobby Lobby? I just couldn't think of anything, but these troll outfits would look really cute in prints. Back in the day when I was growing up, felt only came in solid colors, but now we have prints. And so $10 for all of this. Let me show these to you a little closer. And so these look like maybe they came out of those little machines, you know, the toy machines. Back in the day when they cost us a nickel, I think they cost a lot more, you know, those little plastic bubbles. And then this one here also, this one, the hair is a lot softer, where this one is the type of hair that stands up. And so, but we got three of these. So like I mentioned, my husband Joey is always keeping an eye out for things that I might like miniatures. He knows I love miniatures. This definitely looks like from the 1960s. It's a hard plastic. And so it's a sewing machine. And so you can see the sewing machine. And so, but anyways, it flips out. Look at that. So cute, right? And so I love this so much. And my husband knew I would like this. I think it was just a couple of dollars, you guys. And it always makes me happy when I find something from my elementary school days. And so I remember having one of these in the third grade. And so this is a pencil case. You could see the pencil sharpener right there. And you just slid this open to put your pencils. I still need to clean this out. I think I paid, what did I pay? $5 for this. And so, and then you can see this was a little slide thing. And this is how we memorized our multiplication tables. At least I did. And so like this one says 2 times 4 equals 8, 2 times 6 equals 12, and so on and so on. And it went all the way up to the number 12. And so, but I do remember memorizing them. And then when the teacher called us up one at a time, and she would test us all the time, you know, like if we knew our 2s, our 3s, our 4s. And I always knew them by heart, you guys, because of this little pencil case. And it was only $5. So the next item is the last thing I'm going to share with you. Oh my gosh, you guys, are you ready for this? This is Thumbelina doll by Ideal Toy Company. I got her for $20. Oh my gosh, what are the odds? I mean, this is really hard to find, you guys. and at the same flea market from a different seller, I bought the tiny Thumbelina a few months before for about the same price, $15 or $20. But anyways, look at this one. Oh my gosh, the other one didn't work, but I still love her. She still has the knob on her back. And so right now I just put this little outfit on her. I actually bought the little outfit at Target the other day for $4. It was on sale. But I'm either going to make her clothes like I did with the other one, or I'm just gonna go ahead and pay the 40 or 40 some dollars for the one on eBay. There's another lady that sews the dress. So I removed the outfit so you could see her much better. And so she is 19 to 20 inches. And so look at her little face. It's just adorable, in really good shape. She actually has much better hair than the last one. Look at that. Oh my gosh, she's marked on the neck right here, Ideal Toy Corporation. Again, she was made in 1962, and I was 5 years old. And again, I had the smaller version, the 14 inch, while this one is 19 or 20. This one has the wooden knob. And so from what I understand, the earlier ones had the wooden knob, where the ones after had the plastic knobs. And so, but let's go ahead. And I'm going to wind her up because you turn this. You have to be very careful because she's very old and I don't want her to break now, you guys. But look at her face, so cute. The body is in pretty good condition. She has been loved and played with, but no really big major stains. A little bit right there, nothing really bad. Just a little bit of dirt from being played with. And so let's go ahead. I'm going to wind her up, and then I want you to look at her head because she's going to move very slowly. I can feel the mechanism working right under my thumb. Can you see her head moving? I don't want to wind her too much. Wow. When I laid her down and tried to get her head to move, I couldn't see it moving, but I definitely can see it moving if I hold her up. But just really, really nice. And $20, you guys, oh my gosh. In the comments below, let us know which one of these items is your favorite. Thanks for watching, everyone. I hope you have a great day and happy collecting, everyone. I'll talk to you next time. Bye.